The prevalence of hearing loss is high and rising, but only about 20% of adults seek help. Fortunately, modern technology allows for alternative, more accessible solutions to hearing care. One such example is the Digits in Noise test, which is available directly to the public over internet-based platforms. So, how does a Digits in Noise test work? In an adaptive procedure, digit triplets are presented in speech-weighted masking noise to determine the level at which 50% of digit triplets could be recognized correctly. Previous versions either sequentially tested each ear, taking about 7 minutes to complete, or use binaural diotic testing, where identically phased digits and noise are presented to each ear simultaneously, cutting test time in half. Although binaural testing is fast, it precludes detection of unilateral sensory neural hearing loss. Neither monaural or binaural diotic versions detect conductive hearing loss. This is an important subgroup where medical evaluation may be indicated. A newer version phase inverted the digits in one ear 180 degrees while leaving noise in phase. This is called the antiphasic digits in noise test. By engaging binaural interaction, normal hearing listeners can better segregate digits from the noise. However, antiphasic processing is disrupted in cases of unilateral sensory neural or conductive hearing loss, making the test sensitive to detect those types of losses as well. Therefore, we have a great tool for hearing loss detection, which has combined sensitivity and specificity of more than 85%. Although highly accurate, a single antiphasic digits in noise test cannot discriminate between hearing loss type. Therefore, everyone is referred along the same pathway to the audiologist. Is there a way to discriminate between hearing loss types? Turns out, there is. Using a combination of antiphasic and diotic tests, we can determine three categories of hearing: normal hearing, bilateral sensory neural, and unilateral sensory neural or conductive hearing loss. Normal hearing listeners will be able to pass both tests, while in cases of bilateral sensory neural hearing loss, both tests should be a failed result. Unilateral or conductive hearing loss should fail an antiphasic test while passing a diotic test. Using fixed cutoffs, we could correctly classify 75% of hearing loss types. When using a fixed antiphasic and varying diotic cutoff, we could improve classification to 79%. By distinguishing between these types, we could optimize referral pathways and resource allocation in constrained settings. That's our study in a nutshell. Thanks for listening.